Hi, I'm Mike Rankin, Editor-in-Chief of InDesign Secrets, and in this video, I'll show you how to move pages from one InDesign document to another. Here in my first document, I have three pages with an orange border around them, starting with page one. And this will be my receiving document, where I want to move the pages to. In my other document, I have five pages, and they use Roman numerals, and they also have a blue border around them. So let's say I needed to move the first three pages of this document to the start of the other one. To do that, I can go to the Layout menu and choose Pages, Move Pages. And in this dialog box, I can tell InDesign which pages to move, which document to move them to, and where in that document they should go. So I can type in pages 1 through 3 in Roman numerals. I want them at the start of the document, and I want them to go to document 1. And I also have the option to delete the pages after moving them. If I leave this unchecked, then the pages will be copied to the other document, so I'll have them in both documents. But in this case, I'll choose to delete the pages and click OK. And I get a warning that there are objects on the pages that I'm deleting. That's OK. And now document 2 has just two pages. Document 1 now has six pages, and the moved pages went to the start of the document and retained their original Roman numerals. But there was a big change. Notice that the blue border around the pages was changed to orange to match the other document pages here. Now, why did that happen? The reason is that the pages I moved were based on a master page called A Master. And I can see that if I go back to document 2, and it's right here. In document 1, I have a master page with that exact same name, A Master, and that has an orange border. When I moved the pages, InDesign saw that there already was a master page called A Master, so it simply applied that page to the pages that I moved, and I ended up with the orange border around all the document pages. Now, in some cases, this would be what you want. The move pages match the design of the pages in the receiving document. But what if you didn't want that, and instead wanted the moved pages to keep their original design? Let's see how to do that. First, I'll undo the page move, and in the document that contains the pages I want to move, I'll click once on the A Master, and go to the panel menu and choose Master Options. And I need to change the name here to anything that doesn't exactly match what's in my other document. I'll just change the prefix to B, and click OK. Now I'll move those same three pages again, but this time I'll show you a shortcut. Instead of using the command in the Layout menu, I'm going to select the pages that I want to move in the Pages panel. I'll click on page 1, and then Shift-click on page 3 to select the range, and now I'll right-click on those pages and choose Move Pages. In the dialog box, the page range is already filled in with the ones that I had selected, so I just have to choose which document, and that's going to be document 1. I also want to say where they should go, at the start of the document, and let's delete them after moving, and click OK. I get the warning about page objects. And now I'll go to document 1, and now the pages were moved and kept their original design because they were based on a master page that was also moved to this document. And you can see the B Master right here. And speaking of moving master pages, here's a bonus tip. You can also move just master pages, which is great if you only need the page design, but none of the content moved. So let's see how to do that. I'll undo the move again and go back to document 2, click on the master that I want to move, the B Master, right click, and choose Move Master. I'll move it to document 1, and when I go to document 1, now I can create fresh pages in this document based on the B Master that I just moved. And I'll do that by dragging down a spread. So those are some tips for moving document pages and master pages between InDesign documents. Thanks for watching this video, and if you want lots more tips like this, be sure to check out InDesignSecrets.com and subscribe to InDesign Magazine.